Coming up on the Hacker Show, unlimited free web scraping with GitHub Actions, using GitHub Secrets to hide within open source, launching your own free local proxy server, using iptables to make a proxy server public, and multiple live demos after the previews. Get ready for some serious hacking. So this is unlimited free web scraping with GitHub Actions. And yes, that means bypassing bot detection, such as with the anti-bot services you see below in the screenshot. But first, a little about me. I'm Michael Mintz, and I created the SeleniumBase automation framework, and I also lead the automation team at iBoss. And here's a fun fact. I once showed SeleniumBase to Sam Altman at MIT. And for those of you who don't know who Sam Altman is, he's the CEO of OpenAI, and he also co-founded OpenAI with Elon Musk. But don't worry, you don't need to be one of the OpenAI founders in order to get a SeleniumBase live demo from me, because you might see me at a local Boston meetup, such as Boston Code and Coffee. So it's a popular new meetup where I recently gave a talk. Actually, this presentation that I'll be giving right now. So that was a presentation I gave a few days ago. And if you're not a Boston Code and Coffee member, you might also see me at one of the Boston Python meetups. For details on that, you can just go to the Boston Python webpage. And they also do regular coffee meetups called Python over Coffee. And here's an example of one of the meetups that happened recently for that. So if you like Python and you're in the Boston area, there's lots of Python places for you to go. Recently, SeleniumBase was trending on GitHub, and it got over 3,000 stars within a month period, and it became the top trending repo for any programming language for the month with spoken language English. It became really popular due to some of its advanced features, such as CDP mode. CDP mode provides an advanced stealth capability while you're automating a web browser so that you can bypass bot detection. And that's where lots of the recent SeleniumBase popularity came from. That stealth is enough to bypass bot detection while web scraping from GitHub Actions. If we go over to the GitHub Actions tab I have here, I'm using a repo, MDMint's undetected testing, where I basically demoed this ability where I can scrape data from a website that has Cloudflare protection. You can see here I'm grabbing my YouTube stats. In this example below here, I am web scraping the prices of Nike shoes from the Nike website. And in this example here, I am web scraping prices of hotels directly from the Priceline website. So if you want to know what these examples look like when run directly from a web browser, I can run a few right now. So let's do Python mysocialblade.py. We're going to go through and we're going to bypass the Cloudflare CAPTCHA, and then we're going to go in and scrape the data. And I'm just scrolling the web page here for fun, because you don't really need to scroll this particular one to get the data. And you can see the stats here just as you got it in GitHub Actions by passing the CAPTCHA there as well. Another example that I ran in GitHub Actions that I'm going to run here locally for you is an example where we're web scraping prices from the Nike website. So here we're searching for Nike Air Force One shoes, and then it's going to go through and get the prices of all the shoes that it found. And in the third example I had from GitHub Actions, it was going to Priceline, where essentially we were going to web scrape data right from the Priceline website for hotels in Portland, Oregon, USA. So it's going in, selecting the input that it needs, and then it's going to get a list of the hotels. And then it's going to display that data after it just goes through and scrolls for fun. So you can see some of the hotels that it's collecting data from. And here in the output, you can see the hotels with the prices. So there you go. That's just exactly what was going on in GitHub Actions for the web scraping. These sites all use advanced anti-bot protection, and with GitHub Actions and SeleniumBase together, you can web scrape any data that you want. GitHub Actions is free for public repositories. That's great news if you're on a budget. You can scrape all the data you want. There's lots of power behind GitHub Actions. It's got hosted runners so that you can run your code on GitHub Actions servers hosted on Azure. And don't worry, if you need to hide sensitive information while using GitHub Actions for your open source projects, there's a cool feature called GitHub Secrets, and that removes the limitation of being 100% open source while still being 100% free. Using secrets in GitHub Actions lets you store anything you want inside a string that no one else can see. And you could have over 1,000 different secrets, basically 1,000 organization secrets with 100 repository secrets and 100 environmental secrets. And don't worry, the secrets can be very big because they are limited to 48 kilobytes in size, which is pretty big. And in order to create secrets for a repository, you just go into the settings section, and then you can go into the secrets tab, and then you can view that data, create a secret, and then essentially be able to store all the data that you want. In order to use secrets in a workflow, you can follow the model seen here in this YAML file, where you'll have steps that you set right here. And you can define something such as super secret as an environmental variable, and it'll grab it from the secret that you set within GitHub Actions. And then when you want to use that secret, so after you've set it in your YAML file, you can create a Python file and you can do import OS and then do mysecret equals os.environ with the token that you specified above from your GitHub Actions YAML file. And this will allow you to pass the secret that you created in GitHub right to your YAML file of GitHub Actions and then set it to use it inside your Python file. So that is the secret to GitHub Secrets. And up next, we're going to talk about how to create an instant proxy server, which is faster to launch than making instant coffee. There's a command called sbase proxy, and that's all you have to do. And that basically launches a proxy server using the SeleniumBase dependency proxy.py, which uses that. And also, if you want to modify the default port, you can. The default port is 8899, but you can change it by setting --port=port. And then, as I mentioned before, that proxy server is being initialized via proxy.py. And you can easily configure a proxy with SeleniumBase by basically setting an argument either with a pytest command line option as seen here with pytest --proxy=host:port, or you could also set it with the SeleniumBase SB manager, sb:proxy=host:port there. That's the secret to proxy servers and how to use them with SeleniumBase. How about opening up a proxy server to the rest of the world? Well, there's a cool Linux tool called iptables, which is a very powerful utility, and it comes pre-installed on most Linux distributions, and it basically lets you control and manage the incoming and outgoing traffic that's going into your Linux servers. And if you're wondering how iptables works, here's a quick step-by-step guide covering all the major details that you may want to know. For instance, if you want to connect to your server, you do that, and then you do sudo su dash in order to gain the root access that you need. And then, if you want to list current iptables rules, you could do iptables dash l, and that'll list all the rules currently visible inside your iptables on that Linux machine. And then, to open a port for incoming TCP traffic, you'd use a command such as iptables dash a input dash p TCP --dport 8899-j except, and then you're going to set that incoming port, and you'd do the same for outgoing TCP traffic if you need it, iptables -a output -p TCP dash dash dport 8899 dash j accept, and all of a sudden you've set up your Linux server so that your proxy server can accept incoming connections and essentially be used for anyone else trying to use that proxy server. But if you're already using GitHub Actions, then you might not need to use the proxy server at all. And that is, of course, the secret to making a server public. If you have a nice stack of Raspberry Pis, like in the screenshot here, it's quite easy to connect to them, launch an instant proxy server, and then use iptables to open it up to the rest of the world, assuming your stack of Raspberry Pis is associated with an IP address. Let's move on to some of the live demos, because that's going to be one of the highlights of this presentation. You saw a few earlier where we were doing simple web scraping, but there's of course a lot more examples with CAPTCHA-bypass that you might be interested in. And of course, let's get on to the first one where we're going to be using sbase proxy in order to start the proxy server. And then if we want to see data appearing in that proxy server, we can do something such as, let's see, let's exit that out. Let's go into the, actually the examples folder is good enough. PyTest, myfirsttest.py, dash dash proxy equals 127.0.0.1:8899. And we're gonna launch the test. And you can see that as the test ran, data came in to the proxy server so that you can see the requests that were made. So let's run that one more time so you can see it. It's running a simple test like that, but if we run it and then switch to this window here, you can see that it's filling in the data on here. There are lots of other examples. So for instance, if we go ls, because right now we're in the SeleniumBase examples folder, there's a lot of different examples here. There's also a CDP mode folder, which is specific for the CDP mode tests, because this is the super stealth ability in order to bypass CAPTCHAs in the most effective way. So let's do an example. Python raw-albertsons.py. And this is an example where we're going to basically go to a shopping site, and it's going to go in and do a search for avocado smoked salmon. And then after it does the search, it's going to go through and get the results. So here you have 87 results for avocado smoked salmon. Now let's say we want to run this exact same test using a proxy server. So let's open up the file, open raw-albertsons.py, and let's say we want to set the proxy info here, proxy equals 127.0.0.1:8899, which is basically the proxy server info that we set before. And now we're going to go ahead and run that script, python raw-albertsons.py, and while it's running, we're going to basically take a look at the data coming into the proxy server. So here we have all this data coming in. You can see it's going to collect all that data here. And that data is basically coming in. So for instance, it's got TikTok analytics and cookie law analytics, etc. Basically showing you that you can collect all the data using your proxy server from whatever example that you just ran. Let's do some more proxy automation. So we're going to open raw-tiktok.py and we're going to change proxy settings. So we're going to go proxy equals 127.0.0.1 for the local host and then port 8899. And then once we've set that, we're going to run it. So python raw-tiktok.py. And in this panel here, we're going to see the data coming in. And this shows that the proxy server is handling requests because you can see all this data is loading. And now it's going to go through and just go through the Star Trek TikTok channel. And it's just scrolling now, but it looks like it's already collected the data that we're interested in. So this shows that the proxy server is working with CDP mode. So that's that example. Let's move on to another example where we're going to do the same with the Walmart test. So we're going to go open raw walmart.py, and we're also going to change the proxy settings there. So proxy equals 127.0.0.1:8899, and then Python raw walmart.py. And then while that's running, you can see the data going in. So we're gonna do a search for Settlers of Catan board game, and you can see all this data coming in to the proxy server. So you can see here, it went through. So that's just another example of collecting data via your proxy server. Let's run another example. Let's do Python raw cf.py. And here's an interesting one, because we're gonna bypass Cloudflare protection on Cloudflare's very own website. So let's see if we can do it. Oh, there we go, success. So this just shows you that we can bypass Cloudflare's best anti-bot defenses right on their own site. We're gonna run it again, and boom. Piotr GUI moved the mouse, click the button, and we bypass the CAPTCHA, showing that it is quite possible and quite easy to bypass your CAPTCHAs with the SeleniumBase CDP mode automation. And as we've demoed earlier, you can run all this in GitHub Actions and bypass all the CAPTCHAs that you need to bypass in order to scrape the data that you want to collect. Let's talk about the outline of a GitHub Actions YAML file. If you have a GitHub Actions job that ran, you can click on Workflow File from the Run Details section on the GitHub Actions tab, and then you can see the specifics about what the script is made of. So here we're setting the name, CI build 3, and then you can have the script run on a certain cron schedule. So here, on schedule cron 38 star 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 star, which basically means that this script will run on the 38th minute of every hour. And then you can also run on a push to a branch, or a pull request, or a workflow dispatch. So here we're going to set the jobs, the build, we can set an ENV, we can set the strategy, such as the matrix where we set which OS to run on, such as in this case, Ubuntu latest, and we can set the Python version here. And then with the matrix, we can basically set the steps where it uses actions, checkout v4, and then actions set up Python v5, and then you can set your Python version to use with the matrix with Python version, and then you can give a name, a run command, where basically we're setting up various environmental variables in order to maximize the stealth, and then we can install SeleniumBase dependencies as seen here, and then when we finally get to running the script, here we are. We can do Python raw socialblade.py with dash dash debug. And then there's also the Nike example and the Priceline example, basically showing you how to quickly run your Python SeleniumBase CDP mode script from GitHub Actions with unlimited CAPTCHA bypass. That's the example taken directly from mdmins/undetectedtesting. A repo where I'm basically testing all the CDP mode examples that I have to show that the stealth ability works. Be sure to check out the SeleniumBase GitHub page for all the other information that you might not have caught here today, but there will be more tutorials to come, and we can't wait to show you more. Have a great night, everybody, and enjoy your automation.